I read up on this movie a little bit, and it's about the cat that got stuck in the Griffith Park Observatory, right? That seems really interesting. So I just had a couple questions about the making of the film and how you guys did this. So what was one of the most challenging aspects of making it?
I think getting enough of footage of P22, because mountain lions are known as ghost cats for good reason. They're incredibly elusive, mainly nocturnal, very secretive, actively avoid people if they can. So getting enough footage, and we go into the whole story of his discovery. And this weekend, it's the 5th anniversary that they found P22, actually in the park.
Oh, wow.
In the park, yes. So.
I don't know, do you guys have anything to add to that?
Job at capturing both a human and an animal story, and how people are doing remarkable things, yet this cat has done something pretty remarkable, which is coexist in LA.
Alright, and cross some of the biggest highways that I would never dare cross.
Me neither. I was also wondering, how many hours do you think collectively all three of you have put into the making of this movie? Give me an estimate.
I've dedicated the last 8 months of my life, which I'm very proud to say. It's been a real passion project for me. And just to help a little bit in Save LA Cougars and help provide funds for the wildlife crossing. That's enough reward for me.
That's awesome. And did any of you guys did you start out in high school wanting to go into the film industry, or was that more of a...
Well, my first job in television was researching for David Attenborough, I'm quite proud to say.
Yeah,
but yes, I always wanted to be a filmmaker in wildlife TV, and luckily I fulfilled my ambition.
And what about you two?
So I'm a marine biologist first, but one of the things that inspired me to go into marine biology was watching shows on Discovery, National Geographic, and so I always wanted to do that kind of stuff as well. It's very different doing that than doing research in biology, but I somehow made the jump, and it's been amazing, and I love wildlife filmmaking, and I get to bridge the gap between doing the research and telling people about what that research means and why it's important.
And you think that you might continue working on documentaries, or was this a one-time thing?
For the rest of my life. I've already been doing it for a while, and for about 9 years now.
Oh, wow.
And,
okay. So it isn't entirely.
Yeah, it's not new for me. It still feels new for me because every project is so different from the last, but I love every bit of it.
You know, I'm a conservation leader. I never thought I'd be in a film, but if films like this, if it's what it takes to get protections for wildlife and to do things like build this crossing, then I'm in.
That's so awesome.